Hey, what's up guys? Assassin here, welcome back to another episode of Dirty Bomb. Today we're finally going to craft another cobalt. So I held a poll yesterday on Twitter, maybe a little bit late, and I will probably do it in the future on YouTube. I only got 13 votes, but basically it was a tie between Kira and Nader. So what I'm going to do is just the fairest way I think is possible is just do it on my phone like a coin flip, basically. So here we go. Between Nader and Kira, I give it a nice little auto spin. No sound this time, but hopefully we'll be able to see it. So I believe red is Kira, not 100% sure. Anytime now, please. Yes, stop. Okay, that is red. I'm not sure that is Nader, indeed. Not sure what I said. I said, I think, Kira. But anyways, we are going to craft a cobalt nader. Quite excited for that. First, we are going to open some more cases and I'm going to scrap some cards because I currently do not have 20k fragments, but I do know that I will be able to get 20k quite easily by just scrapping a fuck ton of bronzes. Let's actually quick open all of these. And I also wanted to say, like, CafeDoc is doing a lot of work in Paladins, and those videos get downvoted quite a lot, quite fast, by probably people that don't want to see Paladins but Dirty Bomb. Please just don't. I mean, I'm not going to make more Dirty Bomb videos if you downvote his videos, and he isn't gonna stop making Paladins videos by downvoting it. So if you're not interested in Paladins, totally fine, just don't watch them. If you're only interested in Dirty Bomb, that's fine. Just watch the Dirty Bomb videos and vice versa. So we didn't get anything good from that, by the way. I think we got one bronze. So yeah, I'm going to scrap quite a lot. I need 11 more K fragments. And I will be back and then we're going to craft a cobalt nader. Quite excited for that first nader cobalt that I will have. And also the first cobalt craft, I believe, this year. So yes. Quite sad, almost 4 months into this year, but I'll be back in a few seconds. So I'm back with almost no bronze cards left, but that's okay. We're going to craft a nice cobalt, well, hopefully. So I looked a little bit at Nader's cards, and honestly, I think almost all of them are at least fairly good. Nader is a pretty strong merc, I would say, a little bit newbie-ish, maybe with the grenade launcher, but she's actually really a lot of fun to play. Usually we're on a player I can do quite well. So yeah, this is all of the stuff we can get. Quite a lot of good weapons. Personally, I would hope something with the Krochny or the Hogfur, because that's also a beast of a gun. Because my accuracy isn't the greatest, so the Hogfur is nice and spammy. 50k, please, splash damage, fix this. It's been a year now. This system has been in place for a year now. 50k, that's ridiculous. But anyways, here we go. I thought I would do something more like a confirm something. That, I think, is actually a really good card. It does have the bigger blast radius and the Hogfur. Not sure about Enigma and what is that, less few kick or something? It is shard, that's also dope. Enigma and focus, reduce flinching. Yeah, not really sure how useful that is, but I mean, I can't complain. I'm actually really excited. This shard, that's definitely the skin I wanted. I mean, fragments, okay, but shard, in my opinion, is way better. The M9 and the cricket bat as well. That's actually really dope. Not sad about this at all. So I will see you guys in game, and hopefully we'll be able to test her out a little bit. Give her a little bit of a ride. So just when I was about to equip Nader, I saw that the KE43 that we just got was already my go-to card because it was gold. But I actually really, really do like that loadout, so that's really nice. I'm not sure if I'm going to scrap this one because it is 2k fragments, which is a lot. But then again, it's also gold, which is quite nice. And you can see I have apparently like a bunch of silver naders. So also you can see it is healing quite nicely. So thanks. A lot of you guys were very supportive about it. So thank you very much for that. And we are playing on a terminal as the defenders. But look at that. Really, really nice. My first cobalt Hogfur, I believe. Definitely the first in shard. Does look really nice. The M9 as well. I have to say, like, the texture of this looks really, really good. Especially the gold one in this game. The texture looks so nice on the M9. Of course, you have that... where is it? Little screw-on for the silencer. That would be definitely really cool to see something in the future with a screw-on silencer. See if we can get some kills. Maybe. That's a mine. Don't know why I survived that. Okay, it's a very nice start. Okay, time to stop looking at skins and focus, get some frags. I'm gonna try to get as many frags with the actual nade launcher, just because she is nader. See? Also, did you guys see the preview video of Dockyard? Holy shit, that map. That map looks absolutely awesome. I'm really excited for it to play. Oh, wait. Really excited for that map. Can't wait to play it. Has been, of course, in development for almost, over a year, which is ridiculous. But anyways, hopefully it will be a great map. I'm a little bit worried about the balance of the map. It looked a little bit difficult, maybe, for the defenders, or the attackers, I should say, to attack, to repair the EV. So we'll be quite interested in seeing that. Probably should have used my gun right away there. Can we get... No. But yeah, the map looks absolutely awesome. I am worried, like I said, about being able to repair the EV. Then again, I'm not sure. I haven't played the map ever. Not even in like the testing phase. Oh shit, that's a laser. But I'm really excited about the map itself. And I'm also really happy that it is an actual EV map. Because those are definitely my favorite. I think that's... honestly, the meat and potatoes of Dirty Bomb are the EV maps, in my opinion. I like them way better than these ones. Just the normal objective maps. I'm not sure how you call them. They had a name for it. I'm not sure what it was. I am not doing much at all. Our team is getting wrecked. So, yeah. Pretty sure, actually, the EV maps are called, like, escort maps. Which does make sense. Because you need to escort the EV. See, can we pop some nades there? Yeah, I probably should use my offer a little bit more. We really need to capture the forward spawn. Oh, nice. That insta. That's so satisfying. Getting those insta kills with the grenade launcher. That's just so nice. No, he isn't gonna peek again. Is he gonna peek again? Catch that? Nope. Oh, and that nader is, or proxy is also really low. And I'm out of ammo. Wicked. Yes, I'm aware that they have planted. I am aware of that. Fuse, maybe? I'm not an NG. Let's see. Yeah, I would love to get some ammo, maybe? Nice. Unstoppable ended. I'm playing like shit and I'm still on top. That's sad. Fuck. Oh, I want that kill. Yes, yes, yes. Don't revive yourself. Screw that up big time. And our second best player and only medic is AFK. Awesome. Also, how are you guys progressing on the trinkets? I'm doing quite well so far. I have both unlocked the Wrecking Ball, which personally is my favorite, even though like the ship and the airship are more expensive, more rare. Don't really like them. I think the airship looks real, actually quite ugly. I mean the like particles of it. Whoa, I almost killed myself. The particles of it are definitely cool, but I mean like the airship itself is just not that interesting, honestly. Thunder still annoying as fuck. But yeah, I'm quite confident I will be able to get all of the trinkets within like the next, I believe, 2 weeks. And I have to say, like, they have given us plenty of time to grind for all of the vectors needed. Okay, one more objective. Please don't plant, because I want to test out my nader card a little bit more. Can we get that... oh, they are all bouncing back out again. Nice. Oh, yeah. I'm not the greatest nader player. I haven't played her that much, I would say. Maybe 15 hours from my 500 something hours in total. How is that not a kill? How is that not a kill? Let's see, there's someone on the turret. Oh, those headshots. That's why the Hogfur is such a great gun, in my opinion. Ah, shit. He could have easily revived me. Okay. But yeah, I do really like the Hogfur. Like I said, my accuracy is not that great. Only 25%. I'm aware of that. But yeah, the Hogfur is just a nice and spammy SMG. Which you can really spam a lot with. Because so, see there, also nice magazine size, of course, insane rate of fire. Not sure how much the damage is, pretty sure it is actually the lowest. How did that guy die by those nades? Let's see if I actually can plant the generator. Ooh, thought it was a Phoenix. Okay, they're coming, they're coming. Oh shit, oh shit. No. Nope, nope. Get the fuck out of there. Is there a health station? Yes, there is. All the way back. Nice. Ruining the knife fight. No problem. I'm all about that knife fight ruining. Nice. Someone on the turret again. I think. Oh, that's our turret. Nice. Let's see if we can just flank right around again. Also, really cool. I love the shard skin so much because of the skill trinket. Oh, I almost fucking lost that gun battle. No! At least I got one of them. Oh, there were three of them. Okay, nice. Okay, we're definitely going back to that like tunnel thing. I don't even know the callouts in this game. I've played so much of it, still don't know all of the callouts. There were a few of them. Nope. No one left. And I almost blew myself up again. Nice. What? Oh, that was the Colden, of course. Yeah, that does do a fuck ton of damage, and I probably also was still injured for my own grenade launcher. Oh, they're planting. Fuck. Nice. Fuse. Fuse. Nope. Laser. Kill her. Okay, that... Nice. That proxy is trapped. Or whatever is inside. Yep. A little bit too late, mate. For the... Oh, shit. For the self-heal. Okay, we're trying to shoot some nades in there. Well, only one. One did the trick. Shit, that should have been a hit. Yeah, that's I think the best way to play naders. Just use both the grenade launcher and your primary. No, doesn't make much sense to only go for the grenade launcher unless you're like doing a challenge or something. Yeah, I really would love some ammo. Someone right around this corner. We don't have a single ammo guy, and the ammo crate is captured by them. Wasn't their control, I should say. Come on, one more, one more. There we go. The insta grenade launcher shot. So satisfying. Let's see, he's gonna plant. I'm gonna grab some ammo. Too early. Oh, that turn on. Butch. Okay, I'm gonna grab a little bit more ammo because of. That's the only thing, the only downside with the Hogfur. At least for me, I run out of ammo so fast. Oh no no, always get caught on that little balcony thing. No, don't revive her. Nice. A clueless aura. Oh, that knife. Yep. Come on. Defuse. Repair, I would say. Wanted to say. Do we have a Skyhammer? Nope, we don't. Honestly, it doesn't make sense to go Skyhammer, but like Akira or Stoker would definitely be really nice. Is a motion sensor somewhere? Not sure. Yeah, so the perks on this card, Enigma. Honestly, I wouldn't say it's very useful. Nope, you're not gonna pancake me. Enigma, I don't really like it. I think it's like 60% reduction on the spotted time. Doesn't really make much sense, honestly, because once you're spotted, you usually are dead within like the spotted time. Whoa, that lag. And the other one was focus. Doesn't make very much sense in Dirty Bomb, honestly, but that was it. Personally, I'm really happy. 28 and 12. I'm really happy I got this card, so hopefully you liked it. If you liked it, please smash the like button. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.